Well, news just coming in. The Congress is now mocking the Modi government for seeking help from countries to contain the crisis. Former Union Minister and veteran Congress leader Jairam Ramesh has hit out at the Modi government over its reach out for global help to fight India's crisis. He says, and I quote, "While we should welcome all international help, isn't it ironic that the self-styled Vishwaguru and global pharmacy, a 5 trillion economy to be, has been reduced to this pathetic situation by ego and repeated denial of problem. Yet there's no end to the megalomania and self-promotion." Jairam Ramesh's barbs come after America agreed to end the embargo on raw materials and decide to export surplus vaccines to the world after initially declining to do so. India has also been helped by countries like the UK, Russia, Saudi Arabia and UAE. Anand Patel is getting us more details on that story. Anand, is the Congress as a political party comfortable with what Jairam Ramesh is saying, given the fact that that we are in this together, isn't it? India helped, reached out and helped out America when they wanted us. And I think the gesture is being reciprocated by many other countries now. What's really wrong in that?
Well, yes, there's nothing wrong in that.
Yes.
The point I suppose that Jairam Ramesh is trying to make here is that when the Indian government was exporting medicines and vaccines to other countries, not realizing that they could also face a similar wave in the coming months and not stocking enough for its own citizens. And when this was questioned by the opposition in the parliament in just concluded budget session, the opposition MPs were shouted down. So this is what the point Congress party is trying to make, that without making any preparations, without stocking enough vaccines and medicines here in India, the government went on with its vaccine Maitri program, trying to become the Vishwaguru or the world leader as far as helping out other countries is concerned. And this is the price the people of India are paying. You look at the situation anywhere in any part of the country, be it any state government, Congress, BJP, they're not able to meet up the demands of medicines, of hospitals, of oxygen even. And this is what the Congress party and its leader Rahul Gandhi has been tweeting right since day one. Even when the first wave was there, he pointed out in February 2020 itself that look, a wave is coming, it is going to cripple the economy as well, the government needs to take care of it and make preparations. But the government made mock of Rahul Gandhi and the Congress party and went on with its own plan. So this is what it has come to it. You know, even Sonia Gandhi in his interview today has made similar points that opposition voice must be heard so that a contingency plan is prepared to take on this second wave, which is even more dangerous.
That's right. Anand Patel, thanks for getting us those details, sharing your perspective on that important story.
Hello everyone, this is Rahul Kamal here. Hope you enjoyed this video. For the latest news and analysis, like and subscribe the India Today YouTube channel and don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated.